Passenger rail is the safest, most affordable form of public transport, and many of the country's poorest people rely on it. But already struggling, the Passenger Rail Association of South Africa, or PRASA, was set back even further during lockdown last year when large-scale vandalization of its assets destroyed its infrastructure. Could hope be on the horizon as government puts a new security plan on the table?
It was mid-2020, level 5 lockdown. Passenger travel had been suspended and Carte Blanche revealed how vandals were destroying the country's railway line. The Passenger Rail Agency of South Africa, or PRASA, told us that 3,000 security guards would be deployed by August 2020. Fast forward 9 months and the situation has taken a turn for the worse. Without any workable security plan realized, vandalized infrastructure is but one of many challenges now dragging the state-owned enterprise to its knees. On the central line outside Cape Town, 7,000 shacks have been erected on the train tracks. If one shack houses 4 people, it could mean that nearly 30,000 people have illegally invaded PRASA's tracks.
You've heard of living close to the edge. Well, some of these shacks are putting their lives right on the line. Well, that's if the trains were running.
Cape Town's Central Line is a key service for commuters from all over the Western Cape. While it will cost billions to repair the railway, the service cannot be reinstated if illegal land invaders are not moved. But these shack dwellers say they are not the reason why the trains are not running.
PRASA must fix the cables, then the trains can operate, because the shacks did nothing wrong to the trains. While the trains are not operating, it's not because of the shacks.
Mlondo Lozi Mantlazi is a community leader of the Siyashlale informal settlement, who believes it's PRASA's fault the land invaders are not getting basic services like rubbish removal or sanitation.
We know we're getting in there without permission, but we are there now. We have a right here. There are human rights. From now on, I blame PRASA.
The last trains ran on these lines around March last year, the beginning of lockdown. And since then, the settlement has grown and a lot of the infrastructure has disappeared, like the overhead lines.
Transport Minister Fikile Mbalula maintains the land was invaded during hard lockdown when no trains were running and the shack dwellers are now the state's problem.
The first person who put up a shack there was supposed to be dealt with accordingly, been moved. They've settled there. The numbers have grown exponentially because they know government has got an obligation to find them land.
The minister and PRASA say that this community only started living here after lockdown.
That's not true. That's not true. It's for a long, many years we stay here. Even you can see, even from the cement, you see this cement is not for this year or last year.
Tembela Khadebi says he moved to Siyashlala with his extended family before lockdown.
Sometimes we're struggling to get the money to pay the rent. Then I buy the temporary working because I see the empty space here next to the PRASA's place.
But Tembela, if it is PRASA land, isn't it fair enough when they say that you have to move? It's their property.
PRASA is like it's a national railway line. So what I can say is our government. To get the place to stay, it's not like we asking them for that. They have to do it. Our government have to do it.
Appointed chair of the board last October to turn around the embattled utility, Leonard Ramatlakane says PRASA is working with the city of Cape Town to find alternative land for the community.
I have personally delivered notices that they should leave that place because they are illegally squatting on the rail reserve, some on top of the rail itself.
Minister Mbalula is convinced the community will be gone by June.
The sooner we build the corridors, as we move on, the trains at least will be operational. So once we move the people who have built, you know, shacks on the tracks, half of the job will be done.
The minister might feel that the community is leaving, but it looks like they're staying. They're even building. And that's what Sia Schlala means. We are staying.
The United National Transport Union, or UNTU, the majority labor union in PRASA, blames Mbalula for PRASA's lost infrastructure because he'd suspended the services of 20 security companies in 2019.
What the minister should have done, he should have either continued with those security contracts and knowing full well that he's going to sit with the open line.
Untu says it made several suggestions to Mbalula in the past, which appeared to be ignored.
Had the minister engaged with us or listened to us in 2019 when we requested that the South African Defence Force be brought in to protect the assets only, we would not have sat with the vandalisation that we find ourselves in today.
Mbalula says PRASA only has itself to blame.
No, it was not my decision. The mistake of the board was to suspend them without any contingency plan. But these security companies, if you want my view, they were not helping.
Amid the prolonged security challenge, PRASA believes it will be profitable again. But commuter numbers have plummeted. We visited two stations that are still operational in the Western Cape.
We're at Pineland Station. The security guard says that the trains are running, but there's nobody at the ticket office and not too many people on the platforms, but we'll try and wait for the next train.
We waited for the train for over an hour and met Tina Williams, the only other commuter on the platform. She still often commutes between home and work.
Die oggendtreine het 'n sekere tyd, maar die na 8 het die 'n vaste tyd nie, no. En dan kom hulle nie.
And in the mornings you buy a ticket.
Ja. En in die middag ek koop die ticket, ek travel free.
When the train finally arrived, Williams had been waiting for over 3 hours. Although there were security personnel on coaches, no one checked tickets, and by the afternoon rush hour, the ticket office was shut.
We really did want to pay, but as you can see.
It's not clear whether it's from commuters that PRASA expects to turn a profit, but newly appointed CEO Zolani Khosi Matthews, the first permanent CEO in 5 years, is expected to turn the tide. While he finds his feet, Ramatlakane says PRASA will regain commuters' trust.
The people have lost confidence in the rail transport, but now we are working together with the people to bring back the rail.
Working with people is part of PRASA's newly minted security strategy. Volunteers from communities all along PRASA lines have been selected to assist in guarding the railways.
They are the force multiplier, the eyes and the ears of the police and process what is happening. Because from their homes, they can see what's happening at the stations because they are close by.
The initiative is called the People's Responsibility to Protect PRASA. But the security plan and how volunteers were chosen seem short on detail. Even the volunteers themselves wouldn't tell us anything about their new jobs.
But you don't know anything about the payment or the training?
That is private and confidential.
We've tried everything to get the views of the community volunteers themselves, how they feel about going up against armed criminals, how much they'll be paid, what training they'll get. Either they've been told not to speak to us by PRASA, or they don't actually know.
Reluctant to let us speak to recruits, PRASA representatives eventually briefed one of the volunteers to answer our questions.
How did you go about finding these volunteers?
No, it's not finding them. Volunteers are volunteers. They just come to the station because they're the love of the country.
What will they be paid for their duties?
It shouldn't be something less than, I think, I'm not sure, let's say 3,500 rand.
Nearly 10,000 volunteers have been selected, and if each is paid 3,500 rands a month, taxpayers will foot a bill of nearly half a billion a year.
What role are they going to play? I mean, the community is going to stand there and they're going to see something happening. What they're going to do, they're going to pick up the telephone, they're going to phone the South African police services. Is the South African police services able to react quick enough or respond?
Volunteers will work alongside the police, some Mponto Wesizwe veterans, security companies and reservists to prevent vandalism and, of course, the illegal invasion of railway land.
Minister, can you really assure us that our railways will be in safe hands with this plan? It just sounds fluffy to me.
No, it will work. It is, nothing is cast in stone. It will work, this plan. It's not like before. Just be hopeful that you will see change.
Thank you for watching our stories here online, and please subscribe below to become part of our YouTube community and be notified when we upload our latest content.